I will tell you how many types of compressors are used in inverter refrigerators and how they function. A compressor is an electromechanical device. It also has different types. We will discuss this in some other video. But in this video, I will specifically tell you about how the control of inverter refrigerators compressors works. And how the compressor is controlled using control boards for a complete refrigerator system. And I will name it types of inverter refrigerator compressor control system. Three types of controls are available in the market through which these inverter refrigerator compressors are controlled using a PCB or motherboard. Let me write the name on the board of the first type. The first is the communication system. Now it is obvious from the name is to communicate. Communication is always between two people. At least two people should be there to complete a communication. And both communicators should understand one another. Then it will call communication. If the communicators are not able to understand each other as they are talking, then it is of no use and the tasks will also not be complete. A single person cannot communicate. He would not talk to himself. Always two persons starts a communication. The same is true for the inverter refrigerator compressor. Two control boards are used. In these motherboards, one is the main control PCB. The other is the compressor control PCB. Wires are used to communicate between them. Serial communication is used mostly in the systems. Parallel systems are also available. But the cons of that system is that a lot of wires are used. This is redundant, as many wires are used for communication. It is not necessary to use 50 wires for what can be done with one wire. Serial communication takes place over a single wire. Both these motherboards will be joined together with a single wire for communication. Now communication over a single wire is done, but these are not complete until the others are wired. Now what is the need for a second wire here? That's because we all know whether it is AC or DC electricity. Having neutral and phase or negative and positive is important in it. If negative and positive or neutral and phase are not there, the circuit will not be complete. And then nothing will work. The other wire is important to complete the circuit. That's why that wire is attached here. Communication is through a single wire. But the circuit is completed through the second wire. Then both these motherboards are able to communicate with one another. Now what happens in this serial communication system? I will give a small demo here on the board. The rest I will show you practically on the control board. Now I have drawn the graph of the X and Y axis. The Y axis is represented with voltages. The X axis is representing the time. Now for example 0 to 15 volts are available through which the communication between both the motherboards takes place. The communication is in the form of packages. Let me explain to you how. A discrete voltage is generated when communication is initiated. The main motherboard will generate a voltage package, suppose it generated 5 volts. It will be the starting voltages. 5 volts turned on for some time and then turned off. I am writing it in reverse, but the package initially moves first from left to right. It is an example. The voltages are turned off for some time. Then 15 volts are generated. It turned off the voltages again for some time. 7 volts turned on this time. Which turned off again for some time. Then 10 volts turned on. It turned off again. And the cycle continued. This is how a voltage package is generated. At last, after some time it will generate a stop voltage. This, as a whole is a package that I have made. This package will move toward the compressor control board. Now as the main board initially generated 5 volts. This compressor control board will get ready to receive the rest of the packages from the main board. The compressor control board will know that I am going to get some instructions, so I should get ready. The compressor motherboard will receive all these voltages. And there is coding to run it. I will tell you about that in some other video. The stop voltages in the package will turn on. And this is how the compressor control board came to know what is the main control board trying to say to me. The compressor control board, in the same sequence, sends the packages to the main control board for communication. It tells the main control board that what you told me has been accomplished. This is how the communication control system in the inverter refrigerator works. The second control system is the frequency-based system. As you know, frequency is inversely proportional to the time period. This means that how long are any voltages turned on and off and what is their time period? Let's see a simple example of alternating current. The example is that for how much time period in 1 second does the alternating current move from positive to negative? It moves from positive to negative 50 or 60 times in 1 second. This is called electricity frequency. In DC electricity, the frequency is zero. Because the flow of the electric charge is in one direction, let me explain how this system works. The same 0 to 15 volts are present in this circuit. The voltages will remain the same in this system. For example, the voltages are turned on. These voltages will turn on for some time period, and then it will turn off. It turns off for some time and then turns on. We again let it turn on for a good amount of time. It turns off. And it keeps going the same. Now the on and off time will be considered as its frequency. The longer the compressor will be on and it will be off for as little time as possible. At this time the speed of the compressor is the highest. Because voltages are turned on for a longer time period, this system compressor control PCB is programmed and created in such a way that when it will receive these signals, it will understand that the refrigerator needs more cooling, thus it will make the compressor work at a higher RPM to cool the refrigerator more. Now, when the cooling in the refrigerator is completed, the signals will change. For example, the voltages turned on, but it turned off quicker this time. The off time of the signals increased, and the turn on time of the signals is reduced. First, the on time of the signal was more, now the off time. By decreasing on time and increasing off time, the compressor control PCB will understand that now the refrigerator doesn't need much cooling. In the system, two control board are used. The one is the main PCB and the other is the compressor control PCB. This control board communicates through the on and off time of the signals. As this is a very simple control system and easy to understand, so it is available cheaply in the market. The third control is named the drop-in system. Let me tell you what drop-in means. Drop-in means to throw something downward. Of course, this is it. This means dropping something and completing the task. Now let me tell what components are used in this system. As I have this switch. This switch turns off on the upward side. When we drop this switch downward, it turns on. The point inside the switch joins together in series. When both the point are joined together in series, the function start to operate. So this is a drop-in system. But you might be thinking there is no switch in the refrigerator. So how does this system work? A thermostat is inside the refrigerator. It also works as a switch in the refrigerator. And it mechanism system installed in the thermostat works as a switch. This tube is installed with the thermostat. This tube has gas inside it which shrinks after cooling. The mechanism inside it get pressurized. And this makes the switch on and off inside it. This is called drop-in. Now the question is if it is directly switching on and off, as the normal refrigerator compressor also turns on and off through this thermostat, so why are we saying this system is an inverter? Let me explain to you this because this is its main logic. Now I have this inverter compressor and the drop-in control board which is used to control the compressor. I will explain to you this as well as how it works as an inverter and how it controls the speed of the compressor. Before that, I will install a thermostat with it and pass electricity through it. I have set the thermostat with the control board. Now let me explain to you how I made its connections. I have installed this thermostat with the control board. This thermostat is working as a series switch. And I will join this series point together. I will tell you that too. The blue is the neutral and the brown is the phase wire. The neutral is going directly into the control board. The neutral trace is also going towards this resistor. Let me show you the rest from the backside. This is the neutral trace that is moving through the diode. Then after this point moving towards the resistor. Then passing through this resistor and is attached to this optocoupler pin number 2, which is the negative pin of this optocoupler. The circuit is complete from this one side. With the neutral, it also needs the live connection too. I gave the phase through this brown wire. which is moving towards the NTC sensor. Then the trace of the phase connection moves towards this 315 amperes fuse. This brown soldered wire is attached to the fuse. I soldered the wire here and connected it with the thermostat as an input wire. The series point and the thermostat will join together. The output will flow through this blue wire in the optocoupler. The emitting diode in the optocoupler will turn on. The emitter and collector of the transistor on the other two pins will join together. And this is how the control board will turn on. I have also installed a voltage regulator with the system. I will also check how much current flow through the compressor, with a clamp meter. I will turn on the main electric breaker. The board has been powered. Now I will turn the switch off the compressor control board. And I have set 238 volts on the voltage regulator. The inverter compressor has not started yet. The thermostat is in the off state. I will switch it on first. I have turned it on by rotating it. The compressor has started to work. The amperes or the current flowing towards the compressor is zero. Which means the compressor is working at a very low speed right now. Let me bring the mic closer to the compressor. You can hear the compressor's working sound. Now when the cooling in the refrigerator is completed, let me explain how will it work then. As if right now I turn it off. I am turning off the thermostat. As soon as I turned it off, the compressor also turned off. Normally this would not happen, as the compressor is not installed in the refrigerator system right now. If I immediately turn on and off the thermostat, the program in this control board is set in such a way that if the electricity cuts off, the compressor will also turn off. But if the compressor works for 5 to 6 hours, means the electricity flow in the control board for 6 hours. Then this control board will make the compressor to run because a clock timer is set in this control board. This is because the electric signal in the control board turns off. The main electricity is still flowing in the system. That is why the control board will keep it running under some conditions applied. For example, this control board has been set to this program, that if the thermostat gets off, then for almost 20 minutes make the compressor run at a slow speed. And then turn it off completely. Other than this, the timing of the timer has been set lower than 20 minutes or above it. Then it depends on what brand the control board is. We can also program this control board according to our needs. And then according to our needs make the refrigerator work. But that program is bought by the company that manufactured the control board. The conclusion is this, that the drop-in is a simple control system for the compressor. And is the cheapest of all. This control system is successful and works fine. Now I will test the control board by regulating the voltages to check at what voltages the compressor will stop working. Right now, the compressor is working at 239 volts. You have heard the sound of the compressor. It is working at its minimum speed. I will wait for some time to let it increase its speed. After that, I will drop the voltages. The speed of the compressor has now been increased. Let me show you how much current is flowing through the compressor. It consumes 0.3 amperes. This current is not that much. Listen to its speed now. Now I will gradually start dropping the voltages. Now I have come closer to 180 volts. You can see it on the display, that I am gradually decreasing the voltages. Now I can feel the difference in the speed of the compressor, but it is still working. The speed of the compressor has decreased more. I have decreased the voltages to 150. The compressor is still working. But as I keep my finger on the suction, it is not generating much pressure as it was before. But still, it is working on such low voltages. It consumes the same amount of current and keeps running. I got a lot of comments on one of my videos in which I installed the R600A inverter compressor in an old refrigerator. So the control system used in that inverter compressor was drop-in. Now I hope you understand. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch out next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.